Hi everybody, this is Al, your statistics instructor. Okay, time to start talking about probability and statistics. Let's begin. So, in this short video, what we're going to be doing is introducing a very important concept in probability theory. Key concept that we're going to be talking about here is the concept of an event. Okay? Okay, so, but before we do that, we have to revisit something that we did last time. Okay? So, remember that last time we talked about another very important concept in probability theory? Remember what that concept was? The concept of a sample space. Okay? And related to that concept, to a sample space, remember that we mentioned a couple of ingredients, right? He mentioned a random experiment and also the results of that random experiment, which we call outcomes. Okay, so let's revisit those, and then those concepts are going to help us to introduce the new concept of an event. So here we go. It's going to be easier to talk about events if we do it in the context of an example. So here we go. The example is this. Consider the following random experiment. Tossing a die, a regular die. Okay, so now we have the first ingredient, a random experiment. So, since we're talking about a regular die, we know that the outcomes, the possible results of this experiment would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So we would have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Again, remember that we're going to be using these curly brackets to underline, to emphasize the fact that this list is going to be used to form a set. And since we're talking about the list of all possible outcomes of this random experiment, what we're dealing with here is the sample space. Remember, we use the capital letter S to denote the sample space. We could also use capital Greek O and omega. Either one of them. Okay, so remember, this is the sample space. Okay, now the thing is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 are individual outcomes, okay? Right? They are the simplest result that we could expect from carrying out this experiment, tossing a regular die. But in probability, we are going to be more often interested not just in you know, the outcomes of a random experiment, but some sort of, for lack of a better word, right now I'm going to be using the word combination. So in probability theory, more often than not, we're going to be interested in a combination of these simple outcomes. Okay? Well, for instance, say that we are interested in whether or not the result of this random experiment is an even or an odd. Okay, so if we are interested only in whether the number is even or odd, then in that case the sample space is going to be different, right? The sample space is going to be just this, even, odd. And then we could also do it like this, right? Even would be 2, 4, and 6. Then odd 1, 3, and 5. And this would be a new sample space if we are only interested in whether or not the result is even or odd. So in that case, let me use a different notation here. Let me add, oh, sorry, not what I wanted to do. Let me use a subindex, a subscript 2. And for this guy, let me use a 1. So note that we are studying, right, the same random experiment, but depending on what your particular interest is, then you could define a different sample space based on the same random experiment. Make sense? So this is what this example is illustrating. Even when you have the same random experiment, you could have different sample spaces, depending on what you're paying attention to. In general, it is desirable to employ a sample space that gives you the most information concerning the outcomes of the experiment. So, if we had to choose between S1 and S2, well, S1 I think would be a better choice. It gives you more detailed information about this random experiment that we are discussing here. Now, you could be wondering now, okay, Al, we already talked about that before, about sample spaces, about outcomes. So where are the events? Well, even and odd are events. Note that they are not just a simple outcome of the random experiment. They are again, for lack of a better word, right now I'm going to say they are a combination of outcomes. Okay? Okay. So, let's then introduce, let's talk about the definition of an event. An event is a set of outcomes or sample points. That's another way of saying that these outcomes are the simpler results that we can observe from this random experiment. Okay? So it's another way of saying outcome, a sample point, but by using this term, a sample point, what we're saying is that the sample space that we are using is just formed by sets that are more informative, that have just one element, okay? The simplest outcomes that you can get, okay? Okay. Something more, since we're talking about sets already, okay? Let me remind you maybe something that you have seen before, right? The idea of a subset, right? We're going to talk about the relationship that two subsets could have. And now the thing is, what I want you to see here is that if we want to use a more mathematical term to refer to events, what we're going to be using are ideas from set theory. So, from this, what we can conclude is that an event is a subset of the sample space. Make sense? And let me just remind you how we denote what's a shorthand notation for a subset. Okay. So, and also let me just point that out, what we just said, that an event is a subset of the sample space. Note that an event is a subset of the sample space. Great. Okay. And notation. A is a subset of B in our fancy mathematical notation is going to look like this, right? That funny looking C is what we're going to be using instead of writing A is a subset of B. Okay? Great. Now, remember that if you want to show that A and B are equal, what you have to show is that A is a subset of B and that B is a subset of A. Make sense? So, when you have those two conditions satisfied, then you get to say that A equals B. Okay? Make sense? let's write that down. Recall that A equals B is equivalent to A is a subset of B, and B is a subset of A. Excellent. So, let's summarize what we learned in this short video today. So, a simple event is an event that cannot be decomposed. So each simple event consists in only one sample point, or consists only of a sample point. Okay? Remember that an event is just a subset of the sample space, and that's the main the new concept that we introduced today. Event is any subset of the sample space. And finally, well, as we already know from what we said on another video previous to this one, the sample space is a set that contains all possible sample points using the new terminology that we have here. Okay? Okay. So, well, that's it for now. Take care and work hard. Okay? Bye.